Hey guys, welcome to a new video. In this video here, we're going to take a look at Ultralytics HUB. So this is actually like a pretty cool platform for actually like training your models. It can both handle your dataset, projects, models, it can train them, but they also have integrations with different platforms. So this is a pretty cool tool that I'm going to go through in this video. We're going to cover like all of it that you can do with it. We're also going to see the Ultralytics HUB app, so we can actually like do live update detection with our mobile phone. It comes on both Android, but also on iOS. So we're going to see that in just a second, and it is actually like really cool. But let's just jump straight into the Ultralytics HUB. As we can see here, we have the platform. So this is the interface and homepage. This is still in beta, so they're adding a lot of features over time. We also have the datasets over here to the left, and also the projects, models, integrations. So these are like the main features that they have implemented for now. So the main thing here is that you can actually go in and train object detection models without doing any coding at all. So yeah, let's go over the platform here and see some of the different features that we have. Let's start with the datasets. They also have a tutorial that you can go through, but we're going to cover all of it in this video. So first of all, they just have some datasets already here. So just some standard datasets that you can use. They have some SimSums, VOC, COCO, and so on. So they just have these standard datasets, which is usually used for some smaller benchmarks. We can see that they have 80 classes in the COCO dataset. Here we have like 140,000 images. So that is quite a lot, 20 gigabytes. So we can see that these are actually like some pretty large datasets, but we also have some smaller ones that you can actually like try to go in and train your own model on. We can actually like try with the SimSums in this video here just to see how we can use the Ultralytics HUB to train a model without doing any code at all. You can also upload your custom dataset up here at the top if you have your own dataset. We're probably going to cover that in another video. We can also like do it and make connections with Roboflow, for example, annotate your images and your dataset with Roboflow, import in here. But right now we can just go in and create a project as well. And we also have the models. So we have all the YOLO8, also YOLO5 models. We have all these different models here. We can even see like they are public. We can see the mean error position and also the size of these. If you just click on them, we can go in and see some of the metrics. This is also pretty cool. So down here, we can basically just see like a number of epochs basically on a validation set. We can see the accuracy, mean error position of 0.50 and also 0.50 to 0.95. We can also see the precision and recall. It is just increasing over time. Convert this here at the end. And those are the metrics that they mentioned on the previous page. We can see the box loss, class loss, object loss. So these are just for like the pre-trained models on the COCO dataset. So this is just a general benchmark when we're doing object detection. We can even see these classes here that is inside inside the dataset. We can see the validation, train validation, and test split. So let's just go in and create a new project here. Let's just call it object detection. And then we're just going to create it. There we go. Now we can see we are creating a new project. Now we can go in and create a new model. So first of all here, these are the only steps that you need within the Ultralytics HUB. You can just see how easy it is to actually go in and train object detection model. So we need a data set, we need a model, and then we can just directly train it. So first of all, we need to choose a data set. Let's just go with one of the smaller ones. Let's go with the SimSums again. Here we go. We have 14,000 images. So let's just hit continue here. Let's now choose a model here. So let's just go with a YOLO8 nano model. There we go. We just hit continue. Now we can go in and tune some of these hyperparameters with the number of epochs, image size, patient, device, and so on. If you want to use the GPU or the CPU. Also, if you want to like cache on the RAM or on disk and so on, we can also choose a batch size ourselves. So a custom batch size, or we can just use a custom one. So it basically just uses whatever like is best for your memory on your GPU or like on the device that you have chosen. So then we have some different options here for act like training. So one thing here is that they have this Ultralytics cloud. It is coming soon, but then you will act like be able to train your models directly in the cloud and export the results, but also the model. Now we can also do it here in Google Colab. Again, you don't need to do any code. You can just open it directly here in Google Colab. So in the previous videos, we also showed you how we can do it like step by step, running through a whole Colab notebook. But you can also bring in your own agent if you want to train on a local machine. First of all, you just need to pip install Ultralytics and then just copy paste this code snippet and it will act like train the model for you. But let's just go back here to the Google Colab tab again. We can now open Google Colab. We're just going to go with default hyperparameters here. So right now here, we just need to like do the setup. Let me just zoom in so you guys can better see what's going on. We have the Ultralytics HUB setup. We need to pip install Ultralytics. From Ultralytics, we're just going to have the YOLO class checks and also the HUB. And then after that, we can go in and throw in our API key. So we actually need to throw in our API key. We have the YOLO, and then we can also train. So here we can just directly throw this in. Let's just go in and run the program. So we're going to pip install this one. And then after that's done, we can just go for the next code block, and we have actually trained a custom object detector on our Simpsons dataset. Let's now hit train. We're downloading the weights for the YOLO V8 nano model. And we can see right there we're downloading the model, 176 million parameters. So now once our training has started, we can actually go in and view our model into Ultralytics Hub as well, and actually track how the training performs. We can see the graphs and so on, instead of looking at the metrics here in our Google Colab notebook. But let's now hit this link here, so we just go back into the Ultralytics Hub and view the model. Then we can actually go in here and see the train in progress. So that will just load after like the first epochs. So once our model is done training in our Google Colab notebook, we can actually just export it and use it in our own project and application. So one last thing here that we're going to take a look at is the integration. So right now they have integration with Roboflow. You can use Roboflow to annotate your images, basically to get your labels and your bounding boxes around your images, but you can also do segmentation, instant segmentation, and also basically just optic segmentation with Roboflow. You can connect it, you can integrate with Roboflow, and then you can import your data set and all your annotations. So you basically have your custom data set, and then you can use that data set as I've just shown throughout this video. So also promised you guys to show you the Ultralytics Hub app, which is also pretty cool. You can see it up here. You can basically just run optic detection live with your phone. You can either use like an Android phone or also an iPhone. You can choose whatever YOLO model you want to use, and it's just using the pre-trained models, and then it does detection on 80 different classes from the COCO dataset. So it looks pretty cool when we're just moving around, we're detecting like laptops, we're detecting person. We're basically detecting the classes that we need to detect in the COCO dataset, and we also get pretty high accuracy. We can see that the frames per second is around like 30 frames per second. I'm running this on an iPhone 14 Pro. But again, we are able to run real-time optic detection on our mobile phone, even with like the medium model. We can also go in and download the other models. We can also see the datasets available here in the app, but it's really pretty cool that we can just directly go in and download these different pre-trained models, play around with it, try to see optic detection. Maybe you can even try it out on your own. Just try to move around with the phone. So thank you guys for watching this video here. I hope you have learned a ton. This Ultralytics Hub is really cool. I'm really excited to actually just get more features into the hub so we can do a lot more cool things. So again, that's it for this video. Remember to check the previous videos out where we go over like how you can do object detection, how you can set it up in your own custom Python script. We're covering post estimation, object detection, pretty much everything with the YOLO V8 model. So definitely check that out, or I'll see you in the next video, guys. Bye for now.